Hey everybody, this is GB Wang. In my previous video, I showed you guys some of the limitations that you see when two players spawn a zerg, and especially when they go for an early push. But in this video, I want to show you guys really the power of two zerg, which I think is one of the stronger combinations in the 2v2 in the 2v2 game. And so this is another game that's taken in the Masters League. I have my partner here, best of seven, and spawning up in the northwest is Littlest Pony, and in the northeast is Rick On. So this is going to be a ZZ versus a ZT matchup. And so, since I wanted to show this early push, I wanted to show you a pretty common cheese tactic. And so this is a 6-pool, and I'm going to be 6-pooling. Best of 7 is going to be 10-pooling, and so this is 6-pool, 10-pool, and this actually happens to be a remarkably strong combination in twos games, and this is especially the case on this map, the Ruins of Tarsonis. And there's two reasons for it. One is because this ramp is ridiculously huge, and so it takes a long time to wall. If you use a 10-pool, sometimes if it gets scouted, they can have a complete wall off. But if you use a 6-pool, it's really hard to secure a complete wall off. The other reason why this map tends to favor this kind of play is because if you look on the right side and on the left side, there's these destructible rocks. And the destructible rocks, I kind of think of them as a way for you to salvage the game if they manage to have a wall off, because you can just destroy the rocks and come in at a later time and wipe out their SCVs with speedlings. And so here I go. One of the things I like to do with my 6-pool for 2v2 play is when you do the 6-pool, you end up having 7 drones, and then with 3 larvae you can make 6 lings. But if you do a double extractor trick like I just did, you can crank out an extra pair of lings, so going from 6 lings to 10 lings is a huge boost in the amount of damage that you can do. And in this matchup, I was kind of goofing around. I have this drone over here, and you can always use the drone. If you're going up against Zerg, you can use that drone to place a spine, but not really paying too much attention to it now, and I'm going straight for Terran. The thing that's also nice is with a 10-pool, you have more lings from your buddy that can reinforce you, and with a 10-pool, you can actually get speedling research, whereas with a 6-pool, you can't. So this is kind of an all-in strategy, but when you're engaging these SCVs too, you want to try not to get surrounded by them. Let me just pause it right here. So if there was an engagement, one of the things that would benefit you when you're doing a ling versus like an SCV or probe kind of engagement is in this narrow area between the barracks and the refinery. If they attacked you there, this is a good spot to engage, because you're pretty much engaging either one-on-one versus an SCV or two-on-one. And the zerglings, they attack faster, so they'll end up destroying the SCV faster. So the worst situation to possibly be in is if you get your units surrounded. Obviously now, things are really, they're getting out of control for Terran. I mean, he's just running around. He's not really trying to defend against the 6-pool and 10-pool really well, but the Zerg player even had to pull off some of his drones and attack with his lings in order to try his best to keep this alive. But as you can see now, Terran player is pretty much dead. Things are going to be pretty grim, because it's 2v1. Now for the Zerg player. And so now we know we've messed up the Terran player pretty badly, so now we're trying to be efficient, and we're trying to attack the Zerg player. And so while he's distracted, I end up throwing down a spine. And so if you look now, it's not even 2v1, it's more like 2v1/2, because Littlest Pony, he ended up losing a lot of his drones to that push. I mean, if we just keep flooding in with reinforcements, the game is pretty much over. But he does try to go for some banelings, which is a good adaptation to the 6-pool mainly, a little bit less so for the 10-pool, because with 10-pool you can transition into Roach. It's a little bit sluggish doing that off of a 10-pool, but you can do it. With a 6-pool, it's very difficult to make anything other than lings for the time being. And in this matchup, because I decided to go Roach, which means that I don't really push out until much later in this game. But now you can see best of seven. He started researching metabolic boost. He actually could have done this a lot faster as well. But in this case, it's kind of a moot point, because our opponents are in pretty grim shape. The other thing that I like to do with the 6-pool 10-pool combination is normally when you do a 10-pool, you pull off your you pull off the drones from the extractor. after you get your 100 gas. But if you keep mining and you get another 100 gas, you can give that gas to the guy who's 6-pooled, and so that way he can get speedlings as well. I don't do it in this case, but normally what I do off of a 6-pool is I just convert to an 11-pool speedling build using the 100 gas that my partner gives to me. And so now at this point in time, Littlest Pony, he's managed to get out 3 banelings, but with speedling research just kicking in, it's impossible for the banelings to attack, and they're horribly out of position now. And so best of 7, what he can do is he can pretty much have his way with Littlest Pony's base. He ends up taking out the queen, several drones, and he's trying to stay away from the banelings all the while. Looks like he's going to be trying to pick off additional drones as well. And so in this exchange, he ends up, he's pretty much outnumbered now with speedlings, and there's some banelings over here that should eventually take out those units. But he's got some reinforcements here. And so with the reinforcements, he pretty much takes out the last of the zerglings from Littlest Pony, and he knows the game is pretty much over, so he ends up leaving, and so does Red. So a couple of lessons to learn from this. Unfortunately, this is a very cheesy way to win. I absolutely admit that. But in the Masters League, as you get better in team games, you'll find that the attack windows, especially in twos, they tend to open up sooner and sooner, like with the 6-pool, 10-pool push, or they end up opening much later if they decide to play off of two base. And in twos games, that's really risky. Like, you really don't want to be doing a two base kind of a build at the highest levels, because it gets punished pretty badly. But this this really quick game shows you the power of 6-pool and 10-pool, as well as some of the adaptations that you can make from a 6-pool, which isn't much, but you can always get speedling research if your buddy ends up giving you some gas. So hopefully you enjoyed this quick game and you learned something from it. Thanks for listening, and we'll see you guys next time.